Hello, my name is Emily Schudel, and I'm an instructional designer in e-learning in the Center for Excellence in Teaching and Learning at Camosun College in Victoria, British Columbia, Canada. I want to first take a moment to acknowledge that I was born and raised on the traditional lands referred to as Treaty 4, located on the territories of the Nahiwak, Anishinaabeg, Dakota, Nakota, and Nakota people, and the homeland of the Métis and Mi'kmaq peoples. And I am grateful for the past 14 years to have been an uninvited visitor on the traditional territories of the Lekwungen and Wasanich people. Almost 2 years ago, Camosun College, via a proposal by Sybil Harrison, Director of the Library and Learning Services, and Nanette Plant from Special Projects, Continuing Education and Contract Training, received an open sustainability grant for BC Campus, and in turn funded 8 projects to develop or redevelop courses using open educational resources. The project has brought together 11 faculty members, as well as librarians, copyright experts, instructional designers, curriculum developers, indigenization specialists, graphic designers, multimedia support staff, and others to work on the projects. This session will showcase the projects and the benefits they are bringing to students, to the community, as well as to other programs around BC and beyond. As the first project of its type at Camosun, grant recipients will serve as examples to their fellow faculty members around what it means to collaborate and design for open, as well as advisors for future OER development projects. In addition, the support network created from this project will be better able to provide sustainable support for future projects, provide advice to the college around sustainable practices in OER, and advocate for the creation of policies and strategies for embedding open education into the college's framework. While I will be presenting for 2 faculty members, the others will tell you about their projects in their own words.
Hi, my name is Sandra Carr. I teach a 10-month foundation fine furniture program at Camosun College. My open project was to create a book using press books that focused on all of the stationary power tools in the workshop, because there is no current textbook that's available to teach what we need to teach. So I was excited to use press books, knowing that it would be open source. One of the real advantages, I think, to this is that my students, after they're done the program, are going to have access to the material. So currently, if everything is in the course shell, we use D2L at Camosun, and then shortly after, the students kind of lose access. So with this online textbook, they'll be able to come back and use it after their program is done. And I'm hoping that other trades programs can find use for some of the content. So other trades do use some of the same equipment, so that'll be available. Also, just general interest users could access it, as well as the K-12 system. So I'm just going to flip over to the book, which is a work in progress. And it's been great to be able to sort of work on this and organize all the content in a similar fashion, and I'm finding it really easy for students to navigate around. So we've got our main headings, and then of course all of our chapters within that. I've been writing all my own copy, of course, and then for a lot of the graphics, of which are really well suited to the content, to have a lot of images. Having it be digital means there's no sort of limit on what I can include, and I've been just doing pictures with my iPhone, as well as doing some of my own graphics, and having Camosun's graphic services jump in there as well. And yeah, it's just been a great resource. It's a work in progress. The next thing that I'm going to work on once I've done the writing and the images is to include video, where I can have demonstrations of the content, as well as specific demonstrations for the different projects, so that they'll be very applicable to our current curriculum. I think that's my project. Thanks.
Hi everyone, I'm here to give a very short presentation on my role in Camosun's Open Education Project. My goal was to take a very large 600-page textbook and reduce it. So my textbook was called The Power of Selling. It was about 10 years old and it was very outdated. And so what I did was, this is the front page of it. It's called The Power of Selling. And I work in the marketing department. It's what I teach, marketing and sustainability. And so what I did was I took this textbook and I eventually it was reduced down to 250 pages from an open source textbook with updated sources and updated examples, two new chapters, one on current trends and one on how to close that was missing in the original textbook. And I added some new visuals. And so it became this much more manageable textbook that students could get through with current examples and current research. Some key learnings if you were going to endeavor on a project of a review on a textbook is that it took a long time to review all the sources and the examples to update the material. And so if you were trying to do this, I would have a look at how old the textbook is that you're trying to or you're thinking of updating. It was actually way easier to write the new chapters than it was to review the old ones just because it was so outdated and a lot of the sources didn't work and I spent a lot of time sorting through that. It was nice to have the sort of the overview. So if you start with the chapters that you want to write and then write the chapters to the topics, I think that would be much easier, but do expect it was very time consuming. And so consider the age of the textbook that you're trying to revise. Whether or not it'd be easier just to rewrite, to start over versus a rewrite. And so next steps for me is I'm going to upload to Pressbooks, going to get it into an online format for reading. And I want to make some instructor's aids. I think that'll be key for getting adoption of open source textbooks is for having some instructor help, particularly for anybody who's new to teaching this course. So those are my goals.
Brian Coey teaches sheet metal at Camosun, and his open project was to create new and updated course materials for his program, including student and instructor resources in the form of an open textbook. When Brian started this work, materials he was using urgently needed to be updated. There were no textbooks meeting the need of his program, nor were there industry training authority or provincial resources, even though four BC institutions have sheet metal programs. In addition to receiving funding from Camosun, Brian also received separate support from BC Campus to work on program materials with Okanagan College. There are four levels for sheet metal apprentice training, and Brian decided to take on a small chunk, starting with level one and concentrating on the module for layout or pattern development, meaning the modeling of a 3D object, but showing what it looks like two-dimensionally to start with. Brian worked with a graphic designer at Camosun to create animations and also created videos of himself performing some of his pattern development tasks. I want to show you a bit of Brian's open textbook and where it came from. First, we can see how this material used to be presented to students using two-dimensional drawings with elaborate text explanations. And now we see the same material presented as animated graphics along with text explanations. While creating materials was one of Brian's goals for this project, he also wanted to make them open to help students save money and to provide them with a vetted resource for when they are out in the workforce. Brian has already seen some of the rewards from his hard work. His videos on YouTube have been viewed by people from all over the world. And back in his shop, students now have the opportunity to watch his videos and animations before coming to class and can then go home and review them on their own until they feel comfortable. I should mention that Brian has also received the BC Campus Award for Excellence in Open Education for creating his open textbook, Pattern Development, Sheet Metal Level 1.
Hi, my name is Pooja, and I'm joining you from the traditional territories of Lekwungen and Wasanich-speaking peoples. I teach math at Camosun College. My project started with my desire to offer a good quality digital content to my students at minimum cost. I have listed the four most important outcomes of this project. First and foremost, the textbook cost dropped from about $120 to around $35. My students can now freely access three open source textbooks derived from existing open materials. To help instructors, I have created some PowerPoint slides. Lastly, for students and instructors, there is an infinite number of practice questions tailored to the content. I created these questions on my Open Math platform, and all these libraries are available to use. Here is an example of the PowerPoint slides available for use. Lastly, I would like to show you a question in my Open Math. The information like the angle and the length of the shadow can be randomly generated by clicking on New Version. Each question comes with a step-by-step solution so that the students can easily understand how the question has been solved. Thank you very much for this opportunity to share my work.
Hello, my name is Peggy Hunter. I am an instructor of human anatomy and physiology at Camosun College in Victoria, BC. My open education project involves the creation of a website that allows students to access lab anatomy material outside of the scheduled classroom. Camosun College's anatomy courses, like most anatomy courses everywhere, have weekly 3-hour labs. During that lab period, students have access to an assortment of models and slides. And these models and slides, in addition to various dissections and specimens, are the foundation of our anatomy labs. Now, these courses are very content dense, and typically the students are seeing this stuff for the first time. And they get one exposure to the material, and the next time they see it, it is in the context of a lab exam. Now, some institutions have the luxury of an open laboratory where students can come in at any time and review anatomy lab material. At Camosun College, we don't have sufficient space for that. So in order to give students more access to lab material for study purposes, about a decade ago, I took photographs of all of the models that we use and most of the slides. And a website was developed, which remains a work in progress. Now, the website was designed to give students access to lab material outside of classroom time in a way that they could interact with the material and self-test. I'll show you the website here, and it will take a moment to load this up. This is the homepage for my anatomy website. And if you take a look at the navigation bar here, you can see there are links to models and slides. The site is also searchable, but I think the easiest way is to just click on the navigation bar. And we'll just take a look at one of the models here. This is a mid-sagittal section through the brain model. And you can see a picture of the model there with various structures that are labeled. Now, the way the website works is if students pass the cursor of their computer over a structure, the name of the structure should appear. And this allows students to review and self-test. So all the models are there, and we also have an assortment of slides. I'll just take you into one of the blood slides here. And the slides may also have labeled structures on them. So the slides are identified at the top, and this cell, for example, is difficult to find basically. So basically, that's the website, and it has never meant to be a substitute for hands-on experience. It has, however, allowed students unlimited access to lab content for review purposes, and it has been widely used across both campuses in all of Camosun's anatomy courses. Now, these same models and slides are used everywhere and rolled over, and I think that this site is potentially useful as an open educational resource for anyone who teaches anatomy and physiology.
Hi, everyone. I'm Stephanie Ingraham, the Chair of Physics and Astronomy at Camosun College. I'm working on creating an open textbook on BC campus that will cover the physics of medical imaging and radiation therapy. I teach a physics course for students in the Medical Radiography Technologist program within the Department of Allied Health. It covers topics such as electromagnetic radiation, the structure of matter, electricity and magnetism, X-ray production, radiographic imaging, nuclear imaging, radiation therapy, sonography, and MRI. I was finding that there was a limited selection of textbooks that suit the course curriculum at this level. My goal is to instead create an open textbook that will provide a simple, free way for students to access the course materials. I have been writing modules, creating and finding open source images, and designing original practice problems with solutions. Here I've included some examples of images that I've been working on. Specifically, you can see two types of X-ray production, the diagnostic X-ray spectrum, and a schematic of wavefronts and rays. Next, I've included some examples of the body of the notes. I'm currently launching a draft of material with my course this term, providing an opportunity for student feedback. I hope to revise before publishing at the end of the year. In the future, I plan to expand the textbook by including videos and instructor-specific resources. I'm very grateful for the support and collaboration I've experienced from Camosun's open project team over the past 2 years. I hope that this will not only be useful for our students, but also for students and instructors in similar programs at other institutions, for general physics courses that touch on the same topics, and for anyone interested in the field of medical physics.
Liz Morch is a faculty member in the dental hygiene program at Camosun. A while ago, Liz began to design online modules for her nutrition course in the program, but she quickly recognized the need to provide flexibility in how and when students could access the content. In addition, she also knew of several other programs at Camosun that could benefit from having access to nutrition materials. After searching for OER and open textbooks through BC Campus and Creative Commons, Liz was unable to find existing open content relating to nutrition which would be applicable to her course. Her project, therefore, was to develop online modules for use not only in her course, but as resources for faculty who teach any nutrition courses. In addition, while some individual nutrition components are available through Health Canada, Liz determined that students in her course would require more engaging information. So in her project, she has not only included text-based content, but also images and videos, all Creative Commons licensed or public domain, as well as interactive components to support student learning. Still in development, including adding attribution and licensing, here is the WordPress site Liz has created through the Open Educational Collaborative with support from Camosun College personnel. As the site development continues, Liz will be adding additional evaluation tools in the form of online assessments and additional videos, images, web-based resources, and H5P objects to enhance engagement with the material.
Sarah Erdeyli, Jana, Suraci, and Alex Purdy's goal is to develop a competency-based open educational resource to support learning in Allied Health's 112 patient management course. Allied Health 112 is a patient management course taken by medical radiography, medical laboratory assistant, and sonography students at Camosun College. It is a term one course for brand new students, covering important topics such as infection control before they go to clinical placements. The course was originally created for the medical radiography program. It was expanded in the fall of 2019 to include medical laboratory assistant students and in the summer of 2021 for sonography students. Some of the challenges we are currently facing include the addition of new programs and their required competencies. The textbook required for medical radiography students is not suitable for the other allied health programs. Therefore, the student experience differs greatly by program, even though this is intended to be a transferable course.
Our programs are aligned to professional competency profiles. Therefore, we want to keep these in mind when developing resources. The main idea is to replace the textbook. This word cloud displays the range of topics covered in this resource. As part of this work, we will be re-evaluating which competencies should be included in this resource. This may have implications for the course curriculum. Therefore, we will also make recommendations to the AHT department on areas that have been identified as out of alignment or too discipline specific to be addressed in this course. As a result, we would like to develop some instructional guidelines, recommendations, principles for teaching in an interdisciplinary classroom. This may include an appendix, a list of ideas for laboratory activities that could be developed so that anyone looking to use this resource for their own program or setting benefits from our experience and expertise and understands our shared vision for how this could be used in an allied health post-secondary program or course.
We hope to overcome several challenges that were mentioned earlier. In particular, to develop a resource that caters to all three programs currently at Camosun College and replaces the need for students to purchase a textbook or three different textbooks that an instructor would have to work with. In addition to the cost savings to students, we believe the students would benefit greatly from an open educational resource that considers the Canadian context and emphasizes the specific competencies related to their professional certification in a way that is learner-centric and applied. We hope this will result in greater pedagogical flexibility and ease of sharing while maintaining the academic needs of the course to support program-specific learning objectives.
The next steps for us in the project, aside from finalizing all the individual projects, is to make recommendations to institutional administration based on the lessons we have learned about the time and support required to dedicate time to the creation, adaptation, and use of open educational resources so that more faculty can begin to engage in their own open projects. If you have any questions or want to know more about our project, please send me an email. Thanks so much for watching our presentation.